Hello class, again I am here with the chapter 7 and I want to continue the next part, whatever it is left. So previously we had learned about the document window of the flash and its tool. Now the next part is for symbol and instances. A symbol is a reusable graphic object that is stored in the flash library. Once saved in the library, a symbol can be dragged from the library on the stage, creating an instance of the symbol. An instance is the copy of the original symbol. The size, color, shape, and position of the instance can be altered without affecting the original symbol. We can create any number of instances of a symbol. Next is converting a graphics into symbol. So most of the power of the flash comes from its ability to create and manipulate symbols. A symbol is a master object that resides in one place, a panel called the library. You can generate multiple copies of symbols that can be used anywhere in the flash. Any graphics that we draw on the stage can be converted into symbol. Here you can see a Venn diagram that is created, a symbol. This one is any graphic on the stage that we can draw and we can convert it into a symbol. For this, we have to follow some steps. So select the graphic drawn on the stage, click on the modify, then convert to symbol option. Otherwise, we can click a shortcut key FA, the function key F8. This convert to symbol dialog box appears. Type the name of our symbol here, then select the either the movie clip or the graphic option to define our symbol type. Then click on the OK button. The selected object will be converted into a symbol with be added to the library. Here you can see the convert to symbol dialog box appear here. In this, we have to do the settings. Then we have to click on the OK button and our symbol will get converted and added to our library. Next is creating an instance of a symbol on the stage. For this, what we have to do, once we have converted a graphic into a symbol, we can place any number of instances of it on the stage by following the steps listed here. The first one, we have to open the library panel by clicking on window, then library. We will see the symbol listed in the library panel. Then click on the name of the symbol and drag it on the stage, whatever the symbol we want. Here you can see that the symbol what they have dragged from here, this one is shown in the stage. Then release the left mouse button to create an instance of the symbol on the stage. Similarly, we can create as many instances of the symbol on the stage as we want. We can use free transform tool to resize and rotate the symbol. We can also use the selection tool to move the symbol from one place to another. We can change its location also. Next is inserting frames and keyframes. So in the timeline, we can work with the frames to organize and control the content of our document. We place objects in the frames to appear in our finished content in the desired order. A keyframe is a frame which contains an important steps or change in an animation. First thing, to insert a frame, what we have to do? If we want to insert a frame, so first we have to click on the frame to the left on the which we want to insert a frame. The next, we have to click on insert, then timeline we have to, then we have to click on the this frame option. Then to insert a keyframe or a blank frame, blank keyframe. So for this, we have to select the frame where we want to insert a keyframe. So keyframe, first we have to click on the insert, then the timeline, and then the keyframe, or simply press the F6, the function F6 key to insert a keyframe. To insert a blank keyframe on the this one, we have to click a shortcut key F7. Otherwise, timeline, then click select a blank keyframe. So for the blank keyframe, the shortcut is F7, and for the keyframe, the shortcut is F6. These are the function keys. F6 and F7 are the function key. For the blank, F7, and for the keyframe we have to click on the F6. Next is to insert a multiple frames. So for to creating a multiple frames, we have to select as many as frame we want to insert by clicking at a frame and then dragging the mouse. Then right click on the selected frames and from the shortcut menu select the insert frame option. To delete the frames and keyframes, what we have to do, just to delete a frame, right click on it and from the shortcut menu select the remove frames or clear frame option as required. Next topic is types of animations in Flash. Here comes the types of animations. So the commonly two types of animation are there in Flash. The first one is frame by frame animation. So in this, as the name suggests, it is a type of animation where we need to draw every step of animation in different frames. When the frames are played one after another, the effect of movement or animation becomes visible. Next is tweened animation. Tweened animation is a short form in between. The process where Flash generates intermediate frames between two images to give the appearance that the first image involves smoothly into the second image. Motion tween and shape tween are the two basic kinds of tween animation supported by Flash. So in the tween animation, we have the motion tween and a shape tween. Two types of animation here. The motion tween is a kind of animation that enables the movement of an image from its position in the first keyframe to its position in the second keyframe. And the shape tween is a kind of animation that enables the smooth transition of the first image into the second image. And the next one is saving a file after creating. We can save the files. So to save a file, we have to follow the given steps. First one, click on the file menu and select the save option. Then in the save as dialog box, type the name of the file and then click on the save option. So simply like in other documents, we are saving the document. Here also we can save our animation with the help of these steps. The steps are same. Here are some shortcut keys that we are using in this Adobe Flash ES 3. So these are the important shortcut key, the mostly we are using here. Hope you all have understood the chapter. Thank you.